Here we'll be discussing about the megasporogenesis, that is a development of megaspore in case of Neetam. This is a stout axis containing the nodal region and the internodal region. At the nodal region, a small protuberance or an outgrowth develops. Fine. Now, if you are going to go for the anatomical section of this outgrowth or the protuberance, we have this epidermal cell followed by hypodermal cell. Now, the hypodermal cell, that protuberance is not visible here. We have to imagine the things. Now, the hypodermal cells of this protuberance are going to act as an archisporial cells. Here. So these are the epidermal cells followed by we have the hypodermal cell. The hypodermal cell of that protuberance or the outgrowth are going to act as what? Archisporial initial cells. It is actually eusporangiate type of development where the group of cells are going to act as an archisporial initial cells. Now these archisporial initial cells are going to undergo a pericolinal division leading to formation of an upper parietal cells here, upper parietal cells and the inner primary sporogenous cells. Now these parietal cells, they are going to divide longitudinally, that is longitudinally as well as vertically, that is periclinally as well as anticlinally, leading to formation of a multi-layered wall. Whereas this inner primary sporogenous cell, they will divide, redivide, leading to formation of what is called as an MMCs, that is megaspore mother cell. Now, these megaspore mother cell, they are arranged in a long rows. We can make out here clearly. They are arranged in a long rows. Now, these megaspore mother cell, they are going to undergo meiosis. These meiosis lead to formation of four haploid nucleus. So what is the difference in the Neetam of the megasporogenesis of the Neetam compared to the other gymnosperm is that these megaspore mother cell, when they are going to divide, they lead to formation of a four haploid nuclei, but there is no cell wall formation around these four haploid nuclei. So all the four haploid nuclei are lying freely in that megaspore. So this is called as a tetrasporic condition. There is a no wall formation, so a tetrasporic condition arises. That is the tetrasporic, in the sense female gametophyte develops a character where there is four nuclei lying freely in one cell. This character is similar to that of the angiosperm. Four nuclei, haploid nuclei lying freely in the female gametophyte, we can call this as a synomegaspore. Four nuclei, no cell wall formation around the nuclei. This condition is called as what? Synomegaspore. Now, megaspore which are tetrasporic in nature, they lie freely without cell wall formation around them. So this will be like a free nuclear division leading to formation of what? The number of the nuclei may increase from 250 to 1500. It is like varies in different species. That is like in Neetam ulai, it is about 1500 nuclei are formed. Whereas in case of Neetam nemon, some 250 nuclei are formed. Now there is a development of a central vacuole. Free nuclei are formed. Now at this stage, there is a formation of the central vacuole. The upper part of the gametophyte surrounding the vacuole, it is going to widen. That is, this portion is widened. The upper part of the female gametophyte is widened. Whereas the lower part of the female gametophyte is narrow. It is like an inverted flask, which we can make out here. The upper part of the gametophyte surrounding a vacuole widens, while the lower part of the gametophyte, it slowly starts to accumulate cytoplasm. Thus, the gametophyte becomes an inverted flask-like structure, upper wider part, whereas the lower one is narrower. The wall formation starts very slowly, very, very slowly from its chalaza end, and it move towards the micropyle end. The wall formation is very slow. In the sense, the upper part is like free nuclei are lying freely without the cell wall formation. Thus, the nuclei remain free at the micropyle end and even after the time of the fertilization. Now, the important characteristic of the female gametophyte of the neatum is the complete absence of archegonia, as I discussed earlier. One of the three nuclei of the gametophyte in the micropyle end, they are going to enlarge and enlarge several times and accumulate the dense cytoplasm around them. These large dense cytoplasmic cells are nothing but the eggs. So these are going to act as egg. So this was the description regarding the formation of a megaspores in case of neatum. Thank you.